Hello friends, welcome to BrainScoop channel. This is my new video and our today's topic is how to read CT brain. So firstly we will talk about the lobes of the brain. So this is the frontal lobe, the parietal lobe, occipital lobe, temporal lobe, the olfactory bulb, and between the frontal and the parietal lobe there is the central sulcus. Slice thickness may vary, but in general it is between 5 and 10 mm for a routine head CT. Intravenous contrast is not routinely used but may be useful for evaluation of tumors and cerebral infections. The degree of the X-ray absorption by various tissues is expressed and displayed at shades of the gray in the CT image. Darker shades correspond to lesser attenuation. The shades of gray correspond to the number on an arbitrary linear scale expressed at Hounsfield unit. What has been doing? Changing the setting to preferentially display tissues of interest in image, example bone window, in cases of craniofacial trauma. So there are some description of the Hounsfield units for different materials. So calcium, it is greater than 1000, that is hyperdense. Then for acute blood, it is between 60 and 80, which is also hyperdense. Then for gray matter, it is 38, which is hyperdense also, but in light gray. Okay, then white matter is between 30, okay, so it is hyperdense and dark gray. CSF 0 to 10, which is isodense. Fat minus 50 to minus 80, which is hypodense. And air minus 1000, which is also hypodense and will appear as darkest. Okay. Next, indications of brain CT: acute stroke, transient ischemic attack, acute headache with focal neurological signs, acute head injury, suspected hydrocephalus, mental status change. Secondary indications when MRI not available, including diplopia, CN problems, seizures, and syncope, etc. Indications of CT brain with IV contrast: to look for tumors, infections such as meningeal, enhancement, abscesses, and inflammation. Axial sections of CT brain: posterior fossa cuts, above foramen magnum, level of fourth ventricle, above fourth ventricle, tentorial, supratentorial cuts, third ventricle level, lateral ventricle level, and above ventricular level. This is the normal anatomy of the brain or head in the CT scan. So we can see here are the orbits. Then there is sphenoid sinus, which is here. Then it is temporal lobe. This is external auditory canal. These are the mastoideal cells. And this is the cerebral hemisphere. Now this is next. So this is the frontal lobe, as we can see, okay, and this is the frontal bone, which is hyperdense. Then this is dorsum cellae, then basilar artery, we can see here, this is the basilar artery. Then this is the temporal lobe, okay, these are mastoideal cells, and again the cerebral hemisphere. Of cystine, sulci, and fissures: so a cystine is any opening in the subarachnoid space of the brain created by separation of the arachnoid and pia mater. These spaces are filled with cerebrospinal fluid. A sulcus is a depression in the cerebral cortex, and a fissure is a large furrow that divides the brain into lobes and also into the two hemispheres. So this is the frontal lobe. Then we can see the sylvian fissure here. Then the temporal lobe. This is the temporal lobe. Then suprastellar cistern. This is the suprastellar cistern. Then is the midbrain, which is here. Then there is fourth ventricle and the cerebral hemisphere again. Now we can see the fras cerebri here. This is the fras cerebri. This is the frontal lobe. Then there is anterior horn of the lateral ventricle. Then it is the third ventricle. Okay. Then there is quadrigeminal plate cistern and the cerebellum. Normal calcifications in the brain: pineal gland, seen in 2/3 of the adult population and increases with age. Calcification over 1 cm in diameter and or under 9 years of age may be suggestive of neoplasm. And next is habenula. It has a central role in the regulation of the limbic system and is often calcified with a curvilinear pattern of few millimeters anterior to the pineal body in 15% of the adult population. Next is the choroid plexus, a very common finding, usually in the arterial position of the lateral ventricle. Calcifications in the third or fourth ventricle or in patients less than 9 years of age is uncommon. Now, next is the basal ganglia calcification are usually idiopathic incidental findings that have incidence of less than 1% and increases with age. Usually demonstrate a faint puncture or a coarse pyramidal symmetrical calcification pattern. Flax, duramater and tentorial cerebelli occurs in less than 10% of the elderly population. Dural and tentorial calcifications are usually seen in the lamina pattern and can occur anywhere within the cranium. Next is superior sagittal sinus. Common age-related degeneration sites and usually have laminar or mildly nodular pattern. This is the choroid plexus and the pineal gland calcification, which can be seen. The calcification of flax cerebelli. Next, this is the ventricular system. Okay, so this is the anterior horn. This is intraventricular foramen. Then interthalamic connection we can see here. So this is the third ventricle, fourth ventricle, central canal, posterior horn, okay, and the cerebral aqueduct. So this is the normal anatomy. So we can see the flax cerebri again. This is the sulcus, okay, and C is the gyrus, which is here, gyrus, and superior sagittal sinus, which is here. This is all for today. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.